What's up, YouTube? I'm Sheldon Zan, and today's the 26th of September. The FISMUS Fall protests have continued to disrupt university activities here at NMMU since last week, Tuesday. There's been a call for a mass meeting outside City Hall. I'm going to take you with me and hopefully give you an unbiased, unfiltered perspective as to what's going on. I'm going to take a taxi to get there. So, here we go.
Dude, right now I'm fortunate enough to be with the SRC members here in the taxi, and I've got the opportunity to speak to them about what they have to say about the whole FISMUS Fall movement. What's your heart about the whole thing? What are you guys going to tell the students and the members who are involved today at the meeting?
Ours is to say to our students, we need to take the fight to the current people. Now, ours is to say that the closest entity that we have is international treasury. In November or latest December, so that whatever resolutions that are taken in that report can fall within the budget, understanding that our financial year in South Africa ends in March, so it's before the financial year, and we can make adjustments to say that if we need 25 billion, government can be able to say that here and here we can make adjustments and be able to fund our students who are in need of money.
SREC has identified and noticed a concern from students and their dissatisfaction with the gym being closed during the strike, but we are intending to ensure that the university gets back to track tomorrow. And if needs to be, the SREC will take responsibility to speak to the management from the sports center, particularly Mr. Thomas,
cool,
to try and open the gym so that students who want to pump muscle,
awesome,
and exercise, because we understand the gym is very important, and they paid for the facilities and they need to use them from time to time.
Awesome.
So we'll make sure that the gym becomes open so the students can jump.
Thanks, that's awesome.
At this rate, our university will be shut down for the rest of the year and will be run down if we do not do anything about it. It is then up to you to make your voice heard. As much as we want fees to fall, we need sustainable solutions. Please come to the SRC mass meeting outside City Hall and make your opinion count. Meeting will be at 10 a.m. tomorrow morning. You must walk, drive, take a taxi or a bus, and even a train if you have to. But please be there. Let's take charge and own our institution. Come to the SRC meeting outside City Hall at 10 a.m. and bring your parents, your siblings, and your entire family. Local and international students must come in their numbers. This is their issue. Black, white, colored, Indian, Asian, and all ethnicities must be represented. Straight, lesbian, transgender, gay, transsexual, and the entire LGBTI community must be there to make their voices heard. Whether you are Christian, Islam, Buddhist, Jewish, and all other religious groups, you must grace us. The entire Nelson Mandela Bay community needs to have a say. This affects us all.
And anti-terrorism. myself yet again. But Dylan had to come straight home. Why is it Kuba? Seven to men, I'm a quieter. But someone shall have a song in the low till an art. See, to come over, small eating. They can interdict us, it's fine. They will arrest us, it's fine. All the small fights, it's fine. All the Mulala, it's fine. Doctor, it's the man, Ayo. It's the man, a free education. Now, good.
What's it? Discipline.
Masim Fanenge, comrades. Uba, university, iti, ishatu zayo, azuzuza, uzostata. Ono teksi, bati, abalinde langa, namhlanje, ukusithatha sibothusi. Sithi yathi nake. On the basis of how the university has treated us. Tomorrow there won't be school.
Yes.
Because.
Yes.
Manja.
Yes.
Because it can't be business as usual until we receive a response from the university to say, are fees increasing? Are they in support of free education? Will there be registration for the PUWA in the missile meeting next year? Now we are saying, let us mobilize resources. Let's mobilize energies and masses for a big shutdown tomorrow at NNMU.
Yes.
They have caught us off guard. But now we know that we are no longer friends with them. Now we know that they are enemy number one. We shall never treat them in good faith. We shall never treat them in respect and in dignity, because by their actions they are undermining us.
Yes.
Your comrade.
See, together, my fighting to comrades, I'm confused. See, together, let's decide that we have a clear program for tomorrow. The SRC can agree with the white people and rebels to say there will be university tomorrow. We are saying there will be none of that. Silindile kathina ke singaphambili ukuba so fanele letter sithi you are no longer allowed on campus, it's fine.
Si ready
sithi ke buni, gain courage from us who are saying we will move regardless of any threat. We are saying to you, manana amandla abawuthi xa sinibonakalisa ukuba asoyiki umntu, asinavalo valo dololo. So, let's agree, comrades, that we tried by all means to go to campus. But let's agree that tomorrow we shall do the same. And us leadership will put into place arrangements that will ensure that everyone can go out to campus tomorrow. And we shall communicate. City, Pundi. University is important. City, let's reserve our energies. We shall come to residences late and brief you as to the way forward tomorrow in terms of logistics.
High discipline.
We are saying, give us time as management, as leadership. City.
My name is Sheldon.
Oh, Sheldon, what you're seeing here is a group of students who have been locked out.
Yeah.
They came to mass meeting and have been locked out. What happened was that the SRC and DASO have split up the struggle towards free education and made it political.
Yeah.
As you can see, can you just please pan around? You see EFF colors, you see NNMU colors, you see civilian clothing,
and
you
don't see
DASO colors.
I don't see any white colors.
You see? Exactly. You see EFF.
Yeah.
But everybody inside is?
Yeah.
Exactly. I'm not making this racial or political. Yeah. I'm just pointing out the ironic lines, right?
Okay.
So what you see outside is an agglomeration of students who are basically just wanting their free education. These aren't criminals.
Yeah.
This is just for free education, whether you're DAS or SASCO or even SASCO the bread, we don't care.
Yeah.
We just want free education. Mm. We don't want debt into our things.
Yeah.
Yes, must fall. All these things must
now,
fall.
Holding up the university or taking it to the president who wastes all that money, like delaying the future, that's what we're doing. We're delaying the future, and hopefully they meet our needs eventually, but the university, right now they don't have the money.
They're lying.
Can I say something? You know, one of the responsibilities that we have as the society is to ensure that there's social justice, there's harmony, and there's peace.
Yes.
And for all that to happen, we need to realize this. In South Africa, the gap between the have and the have-not is too wide.
Yeah.
As I'm talking to you now, 75% of the wealth of this country is with the minority.
Yeah.
5% is with the poor of the poor.
Yeah.
And 20% is with the middle class.
Yeah.
Poor people cannot afford education even in lower levels.
Yeah.
In high school, the government is providing free education in high schools.
Yeah.
You see? Now tell me, if I cannot be able to pay 3,000 in high school, how do you expect me to come into a tertiary institution and pay an amount of 40,000?
I must say one thing.
Look,
I
let me tell you something. Okay, let me finish.
Okay.
Do you know that there are students who are on NSFAS?
Yes, me.
Yeah, there are students who are on NSFAS. But tell you what, it's only about 2-3% of students that are having NSFAS which are poor.
Yeah.
Majority of poor people do not have any form of funding.
Yeah.
Besides that, there's about 18.6 million people, students, who are denied opportunity to go to institutions because they do not have financial ability.
Let me say one thing to you.
Yeah.
Would you agree with me that if there's a man walking in a suit, not everyone is meant to walk in a suit. Some people are stronger than me. I'm telling you, some people are stronger than me. Some people think with their minds how to build something. Some people do that. Some people like me like maths. I'm a nerd. I tell you, I'm a nerd. Now, what I'm saying is, not everyone's a nerd. Like, and that's the thing. There are some people who are meant to, or who are just built to, who are good at it. They'll be better than me at it, doing some things that
that's
are hands
at university.
On. Like there's technicons.
We say for education there as well.
Yeah.
We're not saying everybody's built for education.
Yeah.
No, we're not saying
but
that.
But that's, like, for me, that's the picture that's being presented, that everyone in South Africa should deserve
Red
to
means you're not reading enough. That's not our fault.
No, no, it's fine. Okay, well then.
Thanks,
man.
Thanks.
No,
my name is
Mfululu,
it's fine.
Okay.
You can have my name.
Nice to meet you.
That was all the material that I was able to get hold of today. Again, I tried to have it unfiltered and basically everything that went on. I don't want to approach the situation with prejudice or anything. I really hope you found it interesting. If you did, be sure to hit the subscribe button. And if you want the people in your life to see this video as well, then go ahead and share it. It helps a lot. For now, cheers.